How to perform a uterine artery balloon tamponade. So there are numerous uterine artery balloons which are available. You can use a condom catheter. You can actually use a Foley's catheter, but we can also have the option of using a Bakri balloon. For today, for the learning purposes today, I'm going to demonstrate the insertion of a Bakri balloon. So ladies and gentlemen, there are a few components to the Bakri balloon. It's got a tip which projects beyond the balloon. It's got a small tiny orifice that drains the blood from within the uterine cavity. It's got a balloon which creates a good tamponade. Now the benefit of the Bakri balloon, you can actually infuse a maximum of 500 mils of blood. And that is the maximum volume a Bakri balloon can actually hold. If you use a Foley's catheter, you may only infuse a maximum of up to 90 mils. A condom catheter is also expandable, but the rigidity and the compression from the Bakri balloon is superior. Next, it has got two orifices. One orifice is where you insert the CBD bag to drain the blood. And this is another orifice for you to infuse the saline to inflate the balloon. So next, I'm going to demonstrate on how to insert a Bakri balloon tamponade. The principle is to insert it under direct vision, to insert it right until you have reached the fundus of the uterus. How do you know you have reached the fundus of the uterus? You will feel a resistance. And sometimes you can also confirm this on an ultrasound scan. Once you are sure that you are in the uterine cavity, you can infuse fluids until the bleeding stops. So ladies and gentlemen, I am now going to demonstrate a Bakri balloon insertion. So once again, the principles are the same. You need good assistance. You actually need Sims forceps. You actually need good lighting. And under direct vision, use a sponge forceps to grab the anterior lip of the cervix. Use another sponge forceps to grab the Bakri balloon. But do not grab it at the balloon. This may puncture the balloon. So grab it just below the balloon. Under direct supervision, gently introduce the balloon into the uterine cavity. And once you feel the resistance, you can confirm this via an ultrasound. Please make sure you are inside the cavity before you infuse the fluids. Then you may actually place a bag to make sure that you drain the fluid from internal part of the cavity. You connect the bag to this orifice, and then you need to inflate the balloon. A common question which is commonly asked, how much of fluid do you inflate? You actually inflate 50 cc's first and you continue to inflate until the bleeding stops. So please remember, the maximum fluid that you can actually infuse is 500 mils, but you don't really have to infuse 500. You can actually stop once the bleeding stops. So now I've actually inflated 100 cc's. The bleeding looks secured. The next step is to pack the vagina. You can use an abdominal pack to pack the entire vaginal cavity to prevent backflow of blood from inside the cavity. Once that is done, you can continue your uterotonic agents. You can continue your antibiotics. Use the Meow's chart to observe the patient, and the balloon is usually kept for a period of 24 to 48 hours until the bleeding stops. What do you do once you're happy that you have stopped the bleeding? You can deflate the balloon after 24 to 48 hours. Now, how do you deflate the balloon? It is usually done in slow, stepwise manner. Deflate 50 cc first. Once you have deflated 50 cc, monitor for bleeding. If there's no bleeding, you reduce another 50 cc, you reduce another 50 cc, and until you are sure that you have removed all the cavity. It's important to document the amount of fluid which is used to infuse, and then you can safely remove the mercury balloon. So ladies and gentlemen, that is how you infuse and how you use a uterine balloon tamponade.